Meanwhile, Texas at 4-2, 0-2 in the league. The weather conditions today, 53 degrees, humidity 89%. We had some rain overnight, some spitting a little bit early this morning. More rain is forecast. Hopefully things will clear up a little bit. It is a little bit lighter right now than it was when we arrived here at Jack Trice Stadium. The series history is all Texas. The Cyclones have fallen in each of the six meetings. Last season, Texas winning 38-14 in Austin. And we're set to go. Bill and Dave Lapham up top, Jim Knox roaming the sidelines, and Texas will kick it off to Iowa State as Ryan Bailey prepares to boot it off and deep for Iowa State, Jannard Williams and Alan Bell. Sumrall with it, R.J. Sumrall, the 10, the 20, and he is stopped at the 23-yard line as Jordan Shipley makes the tackle. 21-yard return. Liberty Mutual gives us our starting lineups here today. And Iowa State, led by quarterback Brett Meyer. Scales has been splitting the running back spot along with Bass. Bass has been banged up a bit. Blythe, of course, is the leader of that receiving core. And this is a young offensive line that is kind of finding its way.
You're right, Bill, and they had problems against Texas Tech. They regressed. They've been improving every week. They got kind of manhandled. The Red Raiders did a good job, and they're looking to rebound here against Texas, which would be tough duty.
And they've got Bateson as a wideout to start the game, and the first play is incomplete as they look for Blythe. Liberty Mutual will give us the Texas defensive look. The big fellas up front, Loki and Okam, are playing up to their credentials that they bragged about before the season. Their leading tackler is in the secondary, Marcus Griffin, with 49 stops so far for a Texas defense that has not been what it was under Gene Chizik. They're allowing 23.5 points a game, as last year when Chizik was calling the shots, it was at 18. And they have lost their first two league games. Second and 10, and this one is complete to Sumrall. Got a block and jumps it out across the 26 to the 27-yard line. Eric Jackson, the strong safety for Texas, makes the tackle, a pickup of 4 yards.
Todd Blythe had that block you described in your call there, Bill, and he had it against Gary, a linebacker. Todd Blythe can get that done. 6'5", 214 pounds. He's a blue-collar guy. I mean, he obviously is a threat catching the football with his ability to jump as well as that height and catch it at the apex, but he'll get down and dirty and knock people around as well. He's a complete football player.
Once again, Bates, who was recruited as a quarterback, freshman from Omaha, coming in to be utilized as a receiver in this set. Meyer back to pass. He finds Blythe. Got a first down for the Cyclones across the 36-yard line. Ryan Palmer, the tackler. They pick up 9 on the play. Cyclones have won that time of possession battle, even though they haven't won many games.
Yeah, they had the ball for 40 minutes to Nebraska's 20 in that encounter, and this is what Blythe does so well. Big body, uses it to his advantage. It's like boxing out for a rebound in basketball. Blythe gets the inside position on Palmer. Once he gets the inside position, he comes back to the football, which is big. Don't wait for it. Come back to it.
Blythe is 157th reception, second all-time here at Iowa State. And this is Bates and
Scales,
I beg your pardon, and brought down by Jackson.
Eric Jackson.
To the 37. Give him a yard in the play.
And this is what Iowa State's going to have to stay patient with their running game. They may not generate big yards against Texas, but they have to make Texas respect it. They want to stay away from third and long. You have to perform on first and second down to stay out of those third and long situations.
5 wideouts for Coach Gene Chizik. His first year here after a couple of years defensive coordinator of Texas and an outstanding stint at Auburn prior to that as the D.C. This one is complete to Hamilton. He has brought down not much of a gain on this one. What about keys to the game for Iowa State, Dave?
Well, you know, Bill, what they have to do is finish a play. That leads to finishing a drive, finishing a quarter, half, and a game. You got to finish. Tackle. They had 14 missed tackles against Texas Tech. 14 misses. That generated 100 extra yards and 14 points. And like we talked about on third down, they have to be at 3rd and 4 or less, not 3rd and 7 or more. And right now, they're at 3rd and 7 or more. You have to win on 1st and 2nd down so you can execute and stay on the field in 3rd down. And this is their first 3rd and long test of the day. Let's see what happens.
3rd and 9 at the 37 for Iowa State. Senior quarterback Brett Meyer, 6'3", 204 out of Atlantic, Iowa. Back to throw here, got good protection. incomplete. As Foster breaks up the play.
Foster.
Brett Meyer.
Coverage for Texas.
You talked about durability. Boy, he has been the answer to that. Completing his passes at 62% rate so far this year for 1,279 yards. Look where he sits career-wise among NCAA folks.
That's impressive. This is his 43rd consecutive start. There's some luck involved, and there's also taking care of yourself involved. And Brett Meyer is accountable to his teammates. He is there for every snap of practice and every snap of the football game, and the true team leader. They gravitate toward him.
Cosby deep. Mike Brantner, the punter. Cosby saying stay away. Short kick goes out of bounds on the Cyclone sideline, the 41-yard line. A 22-yard punt is all Brantner got, and the average is 40. We'll be right back with more on our Dr. Pepper victory. Welcome back to Jack Trice Stadium on the campus of Iowa State. Cyclones first possession. They punt it away. Great field position for Texas. First and 10 from the 42 for McCoy and crew. On the run.
Uh-oh.
Got a man wide open. Shipley. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And he scores. Texas on its opening play from scrimmage. A touchdown. 58 yards to Shipley.
Can't drop coverage. And that's exactly what Iowa State did. Singleton and Smith dropped coverage. They thought Colt McCoy was going to run the football. I guess they thought he had crossed the line of scrimmage, but no, he had not. And you'll see, the receivers continue their run, their play, and there was a broken coverage as well. Safety bit up in the middle third of the football field. Cornerback thought safety was going to be over the top, helping him cover two. And there was a broken assignment as well. Easy pitch and catch for Colt McCoy.
Bailey for the point after attempt, and Ryan Bailey, the junior from Austin, nails it. He is now, for the year, perfect on 23 attempts, and Texas stuns this big crowd still settling into their seats as McCoy hits Shipley for 58 yards and the touchdown. Longhorn 7. Welcome back to Iowa State. Holiday Inn Express scoring drive for Texas. One play, 58 yards to Jordan Shipley on the opening possession for the Longhorns. We apologize for missing the kickoff. Iowa State got pinned inside its own 10 on its return, but they get a first down pass to Marquise Hamilton and now have it first and 10 at the 20. We'll land Dave Lapp and Jim Knox with you on FSN. And the handoff goes right up the middle, and spinning forward is Jason Scales, averaging 3.7 a carry. Eric Jackson makes the tackle. A 7-yard pickup for Scales, a junior from West Des Moines, Iowa. Dave, be interesting now to see how Iowa State reacts. Right. Team that's already 1-5, and at least they had a little progress offensively in the first possession. A poor punt, boom, 58 yards and a TD. How do they answer here?
Well, and the problem is Iowa State made a mental error. I mean, they beat themselves more than Texas did on that snap. They had a broken coverage in the secondary, and we'll show you.
Meyer chased out of the pocket, fires incomplete to the Texas sideline. Great pressure on Brett Meyer that time as Scott Derry, the weak side linebacker, senior from Pearland, Texas, was all over it.
And little get Brett Meyer out of pocket again, changed the launch point intentionally, trying to stay away from the pressure. Austin English doing a good job of pressuring Meyer, giving him no opportunity. Wasn't faked out by the play action whatsoever.
Iowa State, first down and three. Third and three, I should say. And Scales avoided one, another, and Scales just nearly breaks a long run brought down by Foster, but got the first down on a 4-yard carry.
And that's something that they're going to have to stay with. Iowa State has to be careful to not be one-dimensional. They can't make themselves one-dimensional. Pretty good job of staying after it. And nice ISO, nice little lead block by the fullback, the tight end who was playing fullback on that snap, Barkema, had a nice little lead block. Texas sealed at the line of scrimmage pretty well. Iowa State doing a good job of handling the front seven.
Another first and 10 for the Cyclones. The second on this drive after the kickoff sent him back at the 8.
Play it away.
And this one is complete out on the flat near the 37-yard line. And Ryan Palmer makes the tackle here. He just joined us. Texas answered after stopping Iowa State with a 58-yard TD pass.
Well, Singleton at corner lets the receiver go. He thinks he's got a safety over the top. The safety over the top is biting inside on the route, and that's Chris Brown. And now there's easy pitch and catch, broken coverage. One thought there was going to be safety over the top help. Safety thought he was supposed to help underneath. Lack of communication and a broken coverage in the secondary gives Texas an easy play.
Cyclones trailing 7-0. Scales the back behind the quarterback Meyer on a second and 4. And spinning forward. And again, should move the chains. See where they spot the football near the 42-yard line as Marcus Griffin makes the tackle.
And this is just what the doctor ordered. If you're Iowa State offensively, you want to go on a sustained drive, keep the explosive Texas offense on the sideline, let your defense regroup a little bit, and answer the touchdown that Texas had on their first snap of the game due to broken coverage by your defense.
We're going to measure here a little bit. Offensive coordinator Robert McFarland, former head coach at Stephen F. Austin down in Nacogdoches, Texas, is part of this staff that Gene Chizik has put together. They are not discouraged at all here by their 1-5 start. They know it is a long-haul situation, as you see, first down Cyclones. And Gene Chizik saying, we're going to maintain the plan here. And he mentioned it to us yesterday, so we at least made progress in every game, win or lose, until that Texas Tech game. And he said, we went a step or two back. Hopefully they can now start forward again.
Yeah, and what they did early in this football game is bothersome to a guy like Gene Chizik, because they made a mental error. They've been lining up right, and they've been playing hard. It's the old AAA, alignment, assignment, adjustment. They got lined up right, but they didn't make an adjustment to what Texas did, and they blew the assignment. So you have to get back on the same page, AAA.
First and 10 at the 42-yard line. Meyer, good protection. Blythe, and a rare drop by Todd Blythe. Well, speaking of Coach Chizik, what about what's ahead for Iowa? They're in a meat grinder of the schedule right now. Ooh. Second and 10. And speaking of being meat grinder, how about that for Texas as the Longhorns come through? And that is Lamar Houston getting the sack of Meyer on the play and a loss of 7.
Yeah, and Houston is a big playmaker. This will be his third sack of the season. He's got 7 tackles for loss. And he's going to be working right here at the top of the screen. And he's going to be working against Doug Dietrich, and it's just, you know what, he tries to cut block him and leg whip him, and Dietrich's, he's just too fast for Dietrich. You know, he has that edge speed. If you're going to make a cut block, you got to make sure you make contact. Houston just too athletic. Dietrich threw too early. You have to get closer before you throw at the bottom.
Meyer was sacked 7 times in that loss last year to Texas. He fires here and then gets crushed, and it is complete. That is Blythe makes a sensational reception. A first down at the 41-yard line of Texas, a pickup of 24 yards.
They ripped his helmet off and he still made the catch. I mean, that's focus and concentration on the football. And Blythe runs a good route. He finds a little bit of a seam. And that's a face mask. They ripped the helmet off. How can that not be a face mask? You're ripping the gear right off his head, grabbing the face mask.
Oh, my gosh.
I mean, how can you not call that? That's a flagrant one. And Todd Blythe, in spite of all of that, makes the catch. I mean, that is a tough guy. That is a focused guy. How do you miss the fact that, I mean, he's got a poke in the eye as well. They face raked him, and there's no flag.
That is absolutely inexcusable.
Never seen anything like it. That's what the face mask penalty is in there for.
When the helmet comes all the way off, how do you miss that?
I don't know.
What a catch by Blythe, who's attending to his nose. We'll take another look at that. Look at Blythe.
Oh, he got poked in the eye. I mean, literally, it's like World Wrestling Federation. He got face raked. Because, you know, trying to make a play on the football, reaching and grabbing. Here goes the helmet. And that's a 15-yard penalty. I mean, I know you're just trying to respond and react, but you can't rip a helmet off a guy's head. And the biggest thing, if I'm the teams that play on Sunday watching Blythe make that catch, I'm like, he's got some focus and concentration.
His stock went way up. Second and 7 for the Cyclones, trying to get something going to see if they tie this game up. And they do on the impressive run once again as Palmer makes the tackle after an 8-yard pickup by Scales.
you know, strong safety Eric Jackson is the Texas player trying to make a play on the football. He's just reacting to Blythe and trying to find the ball and make a play. You know, I mean, he got a handful of face masks on that. Scales, look at it, 5'9", 212. If Scales were 6 feet tall, he'd weigh about 235. So it's not like he's not a big guy. He's a short guy. He is put together. That's a nice frame on that 5'9" body right there. He's got some thickness to him, and he doesn't give you a lot of hitting surface at that 5'9" height.
Sets him up for a first and 10. Play action. Meyer's got time, going to Blythe, and it is nearly picked off in the end zone, and a flag is thrown.
They may call interference on Texas, and Texas is saying, what are you talking about? Jackson is involved again, deep with Blythe. Texas defenders kind of peeling each other off there, trying to make a play on the football. The ball a little underthrown. That's the confidence, though, that Meyer has in Blythe. Even though he sees coverage, he puts it up and says, Blythe, you can make contested catches. Go make one for me.
Griffin was leading the coverage back there along with Brandon Foster.
Defense, number 21. It'll be a 15-yard penalty.
Eric Jackson is the infraction is called against 21.
Yep.
Not Foster.
Yeah, Foster was underneath trying to pick the football off. Jackson was back deeper in coverage, and he's the one that got tangled up a little bit. And as you see, he's the one that's bodying up on Todd Blythe, is Jackson. That's where the pass interference came from. There's no face guarding in college football. You don't have to find, but you can't contact the receiver before the arrival of the football.
First and 10 at the 16-yard line. Scales with a flag being thrown, and he is knocked out of bounds. See where they spot it, and we'll check the flag as well. Ocam making the stop on Scales.
They're going to have a hold on Ben Lamont, the big right tackle, 63 in the red. Get the old hook block.
Holy offense, number 63. With a 10-yard penalty, first down.
And Lamont's the guy. Here's a guy that started out as a quarterback, came to the Cyclones as a tight end. They put him in the training table. He likes to eat, a man after my own heart. And here he is right here, and watch him. I mean, see the grabbing the cantilever with the left hand. You can't do that. And that's what he got caught with the hands outside the framework of the body. But now he came to Iowa State like a 240-pound guy. Now he's 6'4", 306. They moved him from tight end to tackle. He's pretty athletic, has good feet. Can't use the hands like that, though.
Sets it up now, first and 20, as the ball is pushed back to the 26-yard line. Scales got a good initial push from his front and then cuts it up inside the 20 to the 19. Killebrew and Jackson the stopper, 7 yards on the pickup. 6:26 to go, first quarter. Longhorn 7-0. They've had the ball one play. It was a TD pass of 58 yards. Mack Brown saw his quarterback McCoy connect with Jordan Shipley. And now Iowa State on their second drive, and very impressive so far.
And Bill, when you're in the red zone like Iowa State was, first and 10 at the 16, 17-yard line, you can't take a 10-yard penalty. In the red zone, you have to be sound. You can't take penalties and knock you out of that red zone.
Second and 13. Scales just powers it forward down inside the 16-yard line. And Rashad Bobineau makes the stop. Junior Lamarck, Texas, and set up a third and long here for Iowa State.
And that's the thing. You have two running plays that generate 10 yards. That's good. That's 5 yards a carry. But not when you're first and 20. And that's what that holding penalty caused. I mean, here you're back to where you started in the red zone. And you had to run two snaps, two running plays to get there and generated good yards. But you shot yourself in the foot and took yourself backwards.
Blythe and Messiah go wide to the left.
Away.
And this one is complete. Bates. Who's that? Scales. Bates. And Bobineau makes the tackle on Phillip Bates, the freshman from Omaha.
And Marquise Hamilton was trying to throw a block down the football field. And this is an athlete. You know, he was showing signs of pulling it back and throwing it. Remember, he's a quarterback. You can't throw two forward passes. That was a forward pass. If it were a backward pass, he could turn around and throw the football. We may see that. Backward pass to Bates. He throws the ball down the field. Can run a reverse, throw the football. They can do some gadget gimmick things with Bates in there.
Culbertson trying a 30-yard field goal. He is 7 of 12 this year. His longest, a 42-yarder. And Brett Culbertson does not hit it. Wow, no good as he hooked that one, and Culbertson misses the senior from Des Moines.
There's a flag on the play, though. There's a flag on the field. The officials are
the
talking about
formation. Offense, there weren't enough people on the line of scrimmage.
They didn't have enough guys up. They were bowing back and trying to get protection for the field goal. Having the old U at the line of scrimmage, you have to have seven men up, and they only had six.
So the special teams mistake by Iowa State, costly here. They get naught. Mack Brown sets up for their second possession. Texas
He's suffering from a hangover, and Oklahoma State not. Oklahoma State had a 17-0 lead and lose the game down at A&M by a point. Heartbreaking defeat on the road, but they've shown resiliency and bouncing right back.
Don't forget later on FSN, Oklahoma-Missouri, a huge matchup in Norman you'll see this evening. McCoy on first down, deflected, nearly picked off. Texas second play today. Smith knocked that one away, and Liberty Mutual provides the starting lineups here. And Texas with Colt McCoy, you see what he's done career-wise, already number seven in just his sophomore season. The big name not on there is Lima Swede. Right. Their star receiver is out for the rest of the season with a wrist surgery.
He's their Todd Blythe, you know, the big receiver that's a matchup problem and unavailable.
Second and 10 at the 20 for the Longhorns. They lead it 7-0. Right across the middle, Cosby makes the grab, his 32nd reception of the year, and he picks up 11 and a first down. Brown makes the tackle. How much will they miss Lima Swede, Dave? This is a guy that was just a huge playmaker.
Well, there is a flag on the field at the conclusion of this play, but Lima Swede is big time. I mean, he is a factor, and he's a tough matchup. And an ineligible receiver down the football field for Texas on this play that's going to cost them negating the gain as well as yardage. And I think they called the big left tackle down the football field, Hills. I think he was engaged. I don't know how they could call him, but the linesman threw the flag, and that's where he's looking at. And if Hills worked himself down the football field, let's see if anybody leaks here in the offensive line. And Hills is 5 yards deep. It can't be him. Who leaked downfield? I don't know who the ineligible guy down the football field is. I don't understand that call. Maybe there was an eligible, he wasn't covered up in the formation, Hill, and he has to be covered up. Maybe the receiver was off the line of scrimmage. He has to be covered up like he is right here with this receiver. This receiver's off the line of scrimmage. He's ineligible, and that's a bad formation. This one is legal. Must not have been in the last snap.
They lose 5, second and 15. Crowd trying to crank it up a bit as he looks deep. Oh. And this one is complete across the 40. And making the reception is Nate Jones. He's now their leading receiver. 30 yards on the pickup as Jones gets the grab, a senior out of Texarkana, Texas.
Well, we saw the numbers that Lima Swede had put up, and somebody has to step up in his stead. He's not available, so they have a core of receivers. And you know what? That means opportunities for others. So, Nate Jones, step up and expand your role. You become more of a go-to guy. He responded right there.
First and 10. This one complete across midfield for Texas. As they spread it around. Obunia makes the grab as Alvin Bell makes the play here. A 6-yard pickup. Liberty Mutual again with the Iowa State defensive group. As this is a team that is no doubt led by the linebacker Alvin Ace Bowen, who led the nation in tackles last year. He leads their team this year with 54. He's also got 6 for loss so far this season.
Very, very active, very intelligent diagnoser of plays.
You saw Bryce Broxma up front. Impressive defender for him as well. And Texas, again, throwing the football. Hasn't run it yet. Pittman, the receiver here. Billy, a senior out of Cameron, Texas. And that will move the chains as well. Keys to the game for the Horns.
Nate Jones got a great block on that one for his compatriot. No hangover. Tough game against Oklahoma. You can't let it affect this one. And they're not. They've come out and they played very well, getting off to a quick start. Make explosive plays. They have to get that done. They won that battle against Oklahoma. Don't turn it over. They don't have a takeaway in the last two games. They have to start taking the football away and not turning it over.
First to 10 at the 38, and another completion as McCoy flushed out of the pocket. And he connects downfield as Bell makes the tackle, but not in time on Nate Jones.
Colt McCoy on the first play of the game for Texas did a nice job of realizing where the line of scrimmage was. When he broke to the line of scrimmage, he knew that he wasn't across the line of scrimmage and threw the 57-yard touchdown pass. Here he's flirting with it again. He has great field awareness, field presence, keeps the play alive, squares his shoulder pads up, and delivers a strike rolling to his left.
He's 5 of 6 for 125 yards. run out of there again. And again, finds a receiver short of the first down. Steps out of bounds at the 11-yard line is Quan Cosby for the Texas Longhorns. Cosby, a junior out of Mark, Texas, 5'11", 200-pounder. First down markers brought to you by Overstock.com. And your entire order ships for just $2.95 at Overstock.com. Live better with Overstock.com. It's all about the O.
You know, Iowa State is playing ball control. They've had the ball a lot more than Texas has, particularly before this drive, but they haven't taken advantage of all their opportunities.
And again, this time they keep it on the ground. As again, they've been throwing it up and down the field. Obunia makes the run to about the 7. Smith is there to make the stop.
And, you know, in this football game, you're seeing Jamal Charles. Some of his snaps are being taken by other running backs. And Jamal Charles, unfortunately, had a tough day, number 25 in the white, against Oklahoma. And he fumbled the football going in for a score. And Colt McCoy threw him a catchable football that he tipped. It was an interception. He's got one that you have to get over and forget about.
McCoy got a keep this time, and he is brought down near the 6-yard line. Curtis Taylor jumped all over him, a junior out of Fort Dodge, Iowa. He's been their sack leader this year with 3.5 coming in.
And you notice Colt McCoy, you know, Bill, earlier in the season, he had too many options and choices in his head, and he was trying to make the perfect one. So Greg Davis said, look, let's simplify. When they do this, you do that. Don't do this, this, or this. And Colt McCoy he's making a couple reads, and then he's tucking it and either creating more time with his feet or running for positive yards, anything he can get. He's making quicker decisions.
He said, don't worry about being perfect. Nobody will do that. Second and goal from the 7. And the handoff as McGee gets his first carry. And Vondrell McGee is stuffed at the 6 as Curtis Taylor again makes the stop for the Cyclones of Iowa State.
And when you're Iowa State, you look for victories to hang your hat on. And if you can hold Texas out of the end zone here, limit this to nothing but a field goal opportunity, that's a victory to hang your hat on and stay in the football game. And if you can somehow take the football away from Texas, that is a bigger victory.
So, third and goal from the 6. Pittman and Jones stacked wide left, Cosby to the right. McCoy now flushed out of the pocket, and it is caught in the end zone. What a grab by Cosby. Touchdown Texas. Boy, does that guy have some hops.
Again, Lima Swede out. Lima Swede in the red zone is the big target. You can run fades to the 6'5" Lima Swede. Somebody else has to step up. Cosby says, I can be the guy. And all he's doing is keeping himself alive. This is like the scramble drill right now. And he goes airborne. You're right. He just out-jumped the defender. Jump ball situation. He had the vertical. Bell didn't. He did. Touchdown, Longhorns. Colt McCoy gave him the opportunity.
Bailey, good snap. Kick is up and good. And Texas, 2 possessions, 2 touchdowns. Once on one play, and then they just march down the field and now lead at 14-0. Iowa State on the short side, 14-0, as Texas, as the first quarter unwinds with just 26 seconds to go, will kick it off here. And the Longhorns, Robinson with Hunter Lawrence diluted, and Alvin Bell and Alexander Robinson are deep. 10-play scoring drive due by Holiday Inn Express, and Cosby with the TD reception. This goes to Bell inside the 5. Bell trimmed up across near the 25-yard line. Hey, College Football Saturday triple header continues tonight with College Football Saturday's regions. Can watch the Missouri-Oklahoma game on special channels on DirecTV and the Dish Network. Go to 672 on DirecTV or channel 444 on Dish Network. Quite a night of college football. Quite a day. Meyer slides it to the 32-yard line. And Loki makes the tackle.
And as this quarter ends, Texas has now gone 11 quarters without a defensive takeaway. Almost 3 football games, which is very un-Texas-like.
It has been costly. Today, no problem so far. End of the quarter, and it's Texas 14. Iowa are in now as the wideouts. As you see, yards per play, Texas dominant there. Of course, you get 58 on your first play from scrimmage. Bumps the average a little bit. That was Jordan Shipley's TD reception.
Yeah, that distorts things. And you know what? I guess now Phillip Bates is going to have to play more wideout. I mean, you're down in bodies right now.
So second down and three, and nearly picked off as defender and receiver both slipped. Our Texas scorer mentioned Shipley getting the TD pass. And for Jordan Shipley, his second touchdown of the year.
Broken coverage. Colt McCoy sees the broken coverage and bust by Iowa State. And then this one, this could have, they're just staying alive. And Cosby takes it away from his teammate. I think he was thrown to the back corner to Nate Jones, and Cosby was in front, and Cosby elevated and said, I'll snatch that thing. I don't think he knew Jones was behind him. Everybody's just trying to, on the scramble drill, get open, and Colt McCoy is converting at a very high efficiency today.
Meyer on third down, flips it, and he bails, running hard, knocked out of bounds near the 39-yard line. Sergio Kindle makes the tackle, sophomore out of Dallas Wilson. He picks up seven, and that will move the chains.
And, you know, a lot of guys are slipping on this football field. It rained last night. I don't think the field was covered. Guys are slip-sliding away some. This time, though, it's just good contact. And there you go, sliding on the tarp on the sideline a little bit. Marcus Griffin, twin brother, playing in the National Football League now. Marcus redshirted. His brother didn't. And he's going to be playing on Sundays as well. The leading tackler for the Texas defense right there at safety.
Also got a pick and has broken up a couple coming in here today. And it's first and 10 for Iowa State, the 38. Blight.
Throwback pass.
And looking for the quarterback, Meyer, and got him at the 45. And that'll excite this big crowd here in Ames as Palmer makes the tackle. But not until they pick up 21 yards, they reverse that passing combo.
Yeah, they did. And Blight showed himself a good athlete there. Nice little toss. And, you know, Gene Chizik is going to have some kind of gadget for his former Longhorn pupils on the defensive side of the football. And he gets them all pursuing. Oh, wait a minute. It's a reverse. But nope, it's a reverse pass. Throwback pass to the quarterback, Meyer. And somebody has coverage on Meyer. They just forgot about him. They booked Meyer. He just leaped out of the backfield down the sideline. He's a great athlete as well. Very well conceived and even better execution by the Cyclones.
And it's first and 10 at the 41 of Texas. Scales. And he'll have an opening. 35, 30. And even looking for an out of bounds line. Bulls ahead before Palmer opposes him a 17-yard pickup.
Boy, back-to-back explosives for Iowa State. Lamar Houston had Scales in the backfield, number 36 in the white jersey. Scales put the old Heisman stiff arm out there and took Lamar Houston, the defensive end, to the turf. He said, Scales is strong. And watch him. He reverses his action, and then he takes it. Oh, boom, right there. And that's a defensive end, Lamar Houston. And he can't make a play on it. That's pretty nice stuff there by Scales. At 5'9", 210 pounds, he's put together.
First and 10 at the 23 of Texas. Longhorns lead at 14-0. Meyer,
go ahead,
trying to hook up with Blount. You know, the thing that might be overlooked here, Dave, with Iowa State is everybody sees this record and they struggled. They lost to some people like Toledo and Kent State. You think, what's going on here? But you've got some seniors that went to bowls, and
right,
they were 7-5 in back-to-back years before last year, 4-6. You've got guys that do know how to win here.
Absolutely, and here we're taking a look at the Big 12 South. Texas trying to fight back from an 0-2 hole, and they're trying to get that done here at Iowa State, trying to come up with their first Big 12 victory.
Cyclones in a hole today, 14-0. It is 2nd and 10 at the 23. And the trip up there. Boy, Jackson makes the stop. Valero, with our look at our standings, you saw the South there, the North, Colorado at 2-0. Who'd have thought that? They've got a huge one against K-State today.
Right.
Kansas trying to go 6-0, hosting Baylor today. Missouri at OU. We saw Nebraska trailing OSU. It's a tough road here for Iowa State sitting in the cellar.
Really, Iowa State at 0-2 and Colorado at 2-0, Texas at 0-2 and Texas A&M at 2-0 leading
the
South. I mean, it's been a crazy start to the Big 12 battles that go on, and it'll be interesting to see how it ends up. You could have division winners with two losses in their respective conference playing for the Big 12 championship.
Yeah, it could very well happen.
Go away, go away, go away!
Throws, and it is complete to Hamilton.
Nice.
and he forges ahead for the first down. Great effort as Foster brings down Marquise Hamilton, the sophomore from Oklahoma City out of Edmond North.
Big wide receiver, 6'3", 220 pounds, and he showed that strength after catch. The last time Iowa State got in the red zone, they self-destructed. Hamilton gets them deeper into the red zone with a second effort after the catch. And that's just running right through the arm tackle. And, you know, Foster's going to have to bring a little bit more wood than that. And Meyer likes the extra effort by Hamilton. And the last time Iowa State was in the red zone, they had the holding penalty, got them off schedule. Then they hooked the field goal. Got to put points on the board this opportunity. Got to score 7.
First and 10 at the 11. And Bass in the lineup gets his first carry. And J.J. tugs it all the way down near the 5-yard line. A junior from Altamonte Springs, Florida. Jackson makes the tackle. Bass, 32 yards rushing, coming in 4 per carry and 4 touchdowns on the season.
And he's battling a little bit of a shoulder problem. That's why Scales has gotten opportunities at the running back position. But what you've created there with Bass having a little bit of an injury problem is more depth at the running back spot. You have a 1-2 punch at running back now instead of just leaning on one guy. Look at those rushing yards. Iowa State is dominating it on the ground, but Texas is just getting big, big chunks in the air.
And it's second down now. Meyer looking for Blythe. Couldn't hang on. And incomplete. Blythe coming in with 2,736 yards and 29 touchdown receptions. Foster was covering.
Yeah, Foster one-on-one. Meyer says, oh, my man, one-on-one, 6'5". Foster does a good job of ripping at the left arm of Blythe. Watch him rip the left arm, get right on the elbow area, and that's what knocks the ball out because Blythe can't secure it. He had him beaten at the high point, and that's what Blythe does so well. He's got good high point ability with his timing and his body control and his size.
Blythe wide to the right this time on a 3rd down and 5 at the 7. And the pitch nearly fumbled, and to what Scales fortunate to hang on to that football, but now sets up the field goal opportunity again. Orakpo made the hit.
And once again, Texas defense pulls their neck in the red zone. They go bend but don't break. Iowa State just can't quite finish. We talked about that being a key. Brent Meyer threw a dart back there right off the smush and was able to recover and maintain possession of the football, Scales. But boy, you gotta execute, gotta finish in the red zone.
Culbertson missed the 30-yarder. Let's see what he does with a 25-yarder here, trying to get his club on the board. This one is good. Iowa State moving the ball very well. This time they get some points to show for it, although they certainly would have liked the 7. But they are on the board. It is Longhorns 14, Iowa State 3. You're watching it on FSN. Iowa as Cosby. And Obunia is deep for Texas. And Culbertson will kick it off for the Iowa State Cyclones. The hooch kick. And it's taken at the 25-yard line. Swarming tackle made near the 37-yard line by Brandon Hundley. Now for Dr. Pepper Gator. That's right. The Fighting Mangino's trying to go 6-0. Boy, they got a heck of a club. Here is Childs, and he takes it to about the 42-yard line. John Childs, if you haven't seen Texas before, you'll see him come on sometimes with Colt McCoy, sometimes replacing him briefly. Bowen and Bell made the tackle on this freshman. He's 6'2", 205. Much more of a runner, as you can see. 17 rushes, 102 yards this year. Against Rice, he had 9 for 72 yards in that blowout of the Owls.
Well, they compare him to Vince Young, but he's nowhere near the size of Vince Young. Vince Young was a freak at 6'5", you know, 240 pounds. But he has got some great ability to make people miss running it.
And that graphic, we apologize, they're not a senior, just a freshman. A lot of potential there. McGee with the carry, and Rubin makes the stop. Vondrell McGee, a redshirt freshman out of Longview, Texas.
Well, finally, Iowa State has Texas in a third and medium. You know, they've done a good job on this possession here, this series on first and second down. Will it pay off? will they be able to get off the football field?
Wayne Bolt, the defensive coordinator for Iowa State. Now, Texas is eighth in the league in third down conversions, 44% on the year. And they face a third and five of the 44, although they have a 14-3 lead. And a 9:44 and counting here in the second quarter. Childs, a word for Obunia.
Texas called a timeout from the sideline.
They have a package of plays that they will use with Childs in the game. And Mack Brown realizing that, hey, he's not only a heck of a talent, you've got to have somebody. Colt McCoy's taken a beating so far this season. He has really been roughed up back there.
And you have to put him in the game when the game still means something. You know? And this can still mean something.
Big third and five coming up for Texas. I want to remind you, Sports Ultimate Nightly Highlight Show is here. The FSN Final Score. It's the only national show that gives you nothing but wall-to-wall highlights. The FSN Final Score nightly at 10:30 p.m. only on FSN. So with 9:36 to go, first half, Cyclones trying to make a defensive stand, if you will. Third and five for Texas on the Longhorns' 44-yard line. And the freshman quarterback, Childs, takes it out of the gun. Little read option and tosses it here. And Obunia goes to the 45, and that will move the chains as Singleton makes the tackle after 11-yard pickup.
Iowa State decided to blitz on this particular play. And a great play selection when the defensive blitz is to run the option. And Iowa State got caught inside with the blitz. They brought six. And Texas got on the perimeter very quickly with Childs. And everybody didn't play their option responsibilities on the outside.
So Obunia picks up the first down. And now at the 45 of Iowa State, Childs again operates out of the gun. Fakes to McGee, keeps himself, and brought down with Baseball. A flag being thrown. Yeah. Banks made the tackle. John Banks, the Sam linebacker.
Well, they saw that face mask. They didn't see Blyce as his helmet was ripped off.
Holding.
Well, they called holding.
No face mask. 66. The 10-yard penalty. First down.
So that takes Texas back. Now you're off schedule at first and 20. See the grab that goes on right here. There's the hold that was called. And boy, didn't hold him very long because he was involved in the play pretty darn quickly. I guess they saw the hands outside the framework of the body.
So they'll march it off here.
Well, change of plans. Penalty was declined. Second and 10. You'd rather have second and 10 instead of first and... Wait a minute. Now they're marking off 5 yards.
Back and forth we go.
So how is it a hold if it's a 5-yard penalty? That was a different penalty because a hold's a 10-yard penalty. So there must have been two penalties. They took I don't understand. It's second and 15.
14 for the 49.
They took the loss. They took the loss in the yards and the rush.
Childs heads out of bounds. You can see the excitement that he adds when he's in the game. Singleton covering on the play.
What happened is there was a rush for lost yardage when the play was made, and they took that lost yardage and said, we'll take the second and 14 instead of first and 20. And so Childs, he's going to make a quick decision. If his first receiver's not available, he's going to tuck it and go, and that's exactly what he does here, trying to make something out of nothing. So let's see if that decision to basically forego the 6 yards to pick up a down instead of 14, now it becomes third and 9. Will Iowa State be able to make Texas punt the football?
Obunia comes in now in the lineup, and he's in the backfield with Childs. Childs going down the sideline and incomplete. We've got basically their number three unit in here, or backups, as Bell was covering on the play that time, intended for Montre Weber, who was a freshman from Hearn, Texas.
I think you have to, look at a lot of your young receivers. Lima Sweet out for the year. What happens if Cosby goes down? What happens if they suffer another injury there? So you need to have other guys to step up. So you want to start to evaluate them, and I think Mack Brown's doing that with a significant snap situation in the evaluation process.
Todd Blythe is deep to take the punt return. Justin Moore, the punter, he punted late in the Rice game and took over the job. Did a great job against Oklahoma last week. Gets this one inside the 20, and the Cyclones scatter from it. Texas will down it.
Flag back upfield. Yeah. There's a little bit of action going on extracurricularly after the play, and involved in it was Bibbs, Michael Bibbs for Iowa State. And it looked like for Texas, was that Killebrew? Who was that that was just knocking people around? At, or is that maybe Spears on special teams? Number 40, there's 240. It's probably Spears.
Yeah, I believe so. We'll see how they sort this one out.
I mean, was it offsetting, or did they just see the second offender?
Personal foul, Texas, number 40, grabbing the face mask. The 15-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down.
Well, you'll take a look, and we'll return after
Here's
this
the drill.
What's the drill?
We'll be right back after this word from Doc. It's day, but the showers have at least gone away. Cyclones trying to put together another drive. First and 10 from their own 27 following the penalty. Bill Land, Dave Lapham, Jim Knox with you. Meyer has this one knocked away. It appeared someone might get a hand on it, but send it down to Knox.
All right, thank you, Bill. The Longhorns defense just got a bit thin.
Meyer is 9 of 17 for 76 yards. He hands this one off, and Scales sheds a tackler. Powers his way, and there's a beautiful line. Is that a flag for you in the sideline?
I think it was warming up here throwing the football in the back. I thought the same thing when I saw that thing roll by there.
Palmer making the stop.
Yeah, Scales has got some power. I mean, he's hard to bring down one-on-one in space. I mean, you know, we talk about his body type, and he's a load, 212 pounds. With he's all hamstring or quads and pectoral. You know, he didn't have much of a hitting surface there. And when he gets a good body lean, he's really hard to hit face on.
He stays in the game. Bates comes in as a wideout again. Meyer nearly picked off, trying to split it to Blythe. And Ryan Palmer thought he had his first pick of the year. He's broken up 11 passes this season.
Yeah, he had great route recognition there, Bill, and broke on the football. And Blythe is trying to run a precision route. He read it. I mean, he turned himself into the intended receiver. That was just tremendous route recognition by Ryan Palmer.
So they'll punt it away as Brantner, the kicker, a sophomore from Bettendorf out of Assumption High School in Iowa. And Cosby, fair catch, right with his toes on the 35-yard line. It's a 35-yard punt for Brantner, and Texas will get it. First and 10 when we come back with 7:26 to go in the first half. Longhorns lead at 14-3 over the half for the Longhorns. And talking about explosive plays this year, you see how Texas has done so well in that category.
Yeah, they have. They've won that battle regularly. Their biggest problem has been turnovers. They've got 10 takes, 14 giveaways, minus four. That's rare in the Mack Brown era.
You mentioned they've now gone 11-plus quarters without getting a turnover. They move it here nicely on the completion down the field. And a pick of a 19 to Nate Jones as Chizik looks on. Bowen made the tackle.
And this is just a good route run. Playing zone defense, Iowa State. Throw the football between the linebackers and the safeties. Find a little hole in there. The runners run right to that spot. Nate Jones is rewarded. McCoy hits him right on the 9.
McCoy, 8 of 10, 157 yards, and the two scores. First and 10 here at the 45, and this one. Another first down, I believe, stepping out of bounds at the 33-yard line as Cosby Bell covering 13 yards on the game for Texas.
You can see how much more quickly he's going to his decision-making. I mean, instead of saying, okay, I could do this, this, or this, as soon as he sees something, it's like, I'm not going to worry about maybe trying to be a little more perfect. I'm going right there, and he's getting the ball out of his hand quickly.
First and 10 at the 33. McCoy, again, comes to the sideline, and it's complete to Cosby. Give him 6 before James Smith, the sophomore from Council Bluffs, Iowa, with a tackle. He came in with 37 tackles on this season. First down markers brought to you by Overstock.com. Save up to 70% on brand-name products. Live better with Overstock.com. It's all about the O.
Texas with 176 passing today, 198 yards total offense. Charles broke one tackle, tugs another defender with him down to the 20-yard line before Chris Brown makes the tackle, picks up seven. Jamal Charles, a junior from Port Arthur, Texas.
Four fumbles in four games carrying the ball on the left arm. That time he didn't have confidence in it, carried it running to his left with his right arm.
Texas on the flip, and Charles, room to roam, and he busted inside the 10-yard line down to the 8, and that will be a first down as well as James Smith makes the tackle. Charles, 622 yards rushing coming in, seven touchdowns. He's got great ability, and he's also a solid receiver. But boy, that fumble thing gets in a kid's mind, and it is difficult to overcome.
Well, to me, watching him run to his left on the rush before that with the ball in his right hand, where he doesn't have his body between the ball and the defense, tells me he has little confidence in that left arm. He injured it. We had him against TCU, and he injured it right before the half, that left arm, and he's had problems with it since.
And Charles, again, ran in, and he scores! He hit a little wall and bounced right off of it, and he's into the end zone for a touchdown. Jamal Charles.
Good balance after contact right there, and that time he did carry the ball in the left arm.
An 8-yard TD run, and Charles has got his eighth score of the year.
This guy runs a 10-1, 300 meters. He's got some quicks, but you saw him really working with his right hand to make sure that that left arm was going to secure the football. You saw him patting the ball with his right hand a little bit after that initial contact. Right now, I think he's got a confidence issue holding that ball in that left arm.
Bailey comes on for the point after. And the kick is good. So Texas tacks on another touchdown. It's 21-3, an 8-yard run by Jamal. Comes in the near side. That is Alan Bell. And he is brought down with a flag thrown at the 22-yard line. And J.G. Kinney with a stop.
Watch Jamal Charles right here. Running to his left. Ball is in his right hand. Now, when you run to the left, you want your body between the ball and the football. He has no confidence in that left arm. I mean, you can get the ball ripped out of there easily. And now the touchdown. He's got it in his left hand. He runs into his own lineman and a linebacker, almost loses the football there. Has to kind of recover with his right arm and cover it up. So Jamal Charles has had four fumbles in four games carrying the ball in his left arm, and he's got an issue with it. And he had the injury against TCU right before the half, landed on his elbow, hit the funny bone, and he doesn't have enough strength in that left arm, I think. And he's struggling with it.
Penalty against Iowa State, so they are in a real hole here. Gene Chizik club first and 10 from their own 9-yard line. The Cyclones have moved the football, but just 3 points to show for 157 yards of offense. They've had 34 plays to Texas 23. Meyer on the throw, looking for Blythe cutting in.
Ball's incomplete, intended for Blythe.
You know, when the field is open, between the 20s, they've moved it well in a tracking fashion. But when the field compresses in the red zone, the Texas athletes really step up. I mean, there's less room to operate, and now the holes are, the windows are tighter, the holes are smaller, and Iowa State, many, they self-destructed. Penalty and just field goals, and they've just had red zone issues for sure.
Second and 10 from the 9. Meyer out of the shotgun, and the keeper forges out to pick up 5 or 6. We'll see what they give him. Killebrew makes the tackle here, the senior out of Spring, Texas, in the Houston area. And Meyer got, we'll give him 3. It'll be 3rd and 7 now. Glad to have you with us here at Jack Trice Stadium in Ames, Iowa. Iowa State on the short side, 21-3. Texas scored on their first possession on a 58-yard TD pass. McCoy to Shipley. Cosby on a TD reception. Then ISU got a field goal from Culbertson before Charles' 8-yard run a moment ago. And the Cyclones down 18. Meyer completes this one on a 3rd down and 7. And they won't get it as Scales, brought down by Ocam and Palmer, coming in to combine for the stop.
Well, our great statistician, Chris Andringa, gave me a great number here. You have to be productive on 1st and 2nd down to have 3rd down success. The last 4 first down plays for Iowa State, no gain, 4-yard gain, no gain, no gain. When you're averaging 1 yard on first down on your last four snaps, you're in a lot of second and third and longs.
So here's Brantner to try to boot him out of trouble. He has struggled. High kick, but very short. Cosby, the punt return man, telling people, get away. And it rolls in Iowa State's favor out near the 47-yard line. Another flag is thrown back on about the 25-yard line.
I think they got Killebrew again. Killebrew, the way he's reacting body language-wise, yeah. He can't believe it. Killebrew had the face mask on the last little kick episode.
Personal foul, number 40.
Got him again.
Texas, 15-yard penalty, first and 10.
He's not happy, and everybody's staying away from him. You can't believe it. And he's frustrated, and talking to Mac Brown about it. Usually, it's the retaliatory move. Sometimes the guy that instigates gets away with it, and the guy that reacts to the instigator doesn't get away with it.
Well, maybe the official kind of mentioned Gene Chizzy too. All right, these two guys, the Killebrew's gotten the penalty, but hey, your guy's not completely innocent. I got a feeling that until both of them clean it up, let's play football.
Right.
First and 10 on the 39 with Texas with Colt McCoy back in running the show.
49.
McCoy, a pair of TD passes today. He has been brilliant, 10 of 12 through the air. Time again, and this one incomplete. Send it down earlier this week. He said, whoa, wait a minute. Their team has put a chill on Iowa State so far, though. Second and 10 on the 39 now. Pittman on the look in and then goes right back upfield across the 45. And shy of the first down, Bell and Broxma making the stop for the Cyclones of Iowa State.
Texas, on the other hand, their first down field. Chris coming up large once again. 225 yards offense, 148 of those on first down. Two-thirds of it, 66% of the yards are on first down execution. So one team is dominant on first down, the other team struggling on first down. That makes third down easier, and that makes scoring easier.
And it is third and one. Charles has got the one and the first down at the 50-yard line. Banks making the tackle. Well, you know, Mac Brown is
all in the right hand again, running to his left, Bill.
And he's got to be thinking, all right, we've got to continue, and this is a good game to do it in right now. They have control of the game. We've still got to get Charles. He's got to carry the football. You can't just hide him.
Exactly. And he has to get his confidence back. There's nothing worse than having the turnovers that he had last week, knowing that both turnovers were monumental in the outcome of the football game, that his team played well. And he did for the most part, too, except for those couple of snaps, which were huge snaps. You have to rebuild his confidence.
First and 10 after that run by Charles. He faked to Obanaya. Now they throw to him and almost comes up with it. Obanaya had Bowen covering him on the play. Well, yeah, Texas, we talked a little bit earlier that in Mac Brown's era, they have had 10 games in which they've had no turnovers, that they have
no takeaways.
No takeaways, and they've gone 4-6.
Right.
And the last two games are two of those 10, and they lost both of them to Kansas State and then to Oklahoma last weekend. And there's a graphic that points it out. And
20-point differential, you know, I mean. When you're minus six, that's not that bad a 20-point differential. They're perfect. They're possible.
Pittman from McCoy picks up a couple on the second and 10. Banks backs the tackle. There's Mac Brown. He was an assistant here. In fact, offensive coordinator for 1 year at Iowa State University, 79-81.
Johnny Duncan was the head coach.
Yeah.
A good buddy with a big friend of everybody in the Big 12.
Been a lot of big-name coaches that have come through here at one time. Jackie Sherrill of our FSN studio crew was, of course, up here. And
Mac had a lot of hair, didn't he?
Yeah. Jimmy Johnson was an assistant at Iowa State at one time. This one complete to Cosby, and he strolls down to the 33-yard line, a pickup of 14. And we had a chance to visit with Mac, find out his thoughts about coaching at Iowa State.
Well, I had black hair, and it was long, and I was coaching with Donnie Duncan, and we had a great time. Ames is a wonderful place. It's got Great people, and I love the state of Iowa, and it's always fun to come back.
Well, you were mentioning some of the guys. Johnny Major's staff had Jackie Sherrill and Jimmy Johnson on it. Unbelievable staff.
Here's Charles, and he is brought down at the 26-yard line. And Sean Parker, the end, makes the stop for Iowa State. Parker, a sophomore from Ponca City, Oklahoma. Charles, the last touchdown in the game.
Greg Davis, Bill, starting to mix it well. Mixing the run and pass on this drive and really kind of putting Iowa State's defense in the meat grinder a little bit.
Second down and four at the 27. McCoy, plenty of time.
Oh.
Just pick them apart. And then Pittman makes the reception before stepping out of the 20. Singleton covered.
One-handed catch. Got the left mucker up there, controlled the football. And, you know, he got both feet down. And that's just an unbelievable body control. Concentration. Look at the left hand. Whoop, stick right on there and then get out of bounds. Pretty nice stuff right there by Pittman. Control it. Bring it in.
Honorable mention, all-conference pick last year. 35 grabs, 456 yards and four scores. Missed a couple for some disciplinary stuff. Working his way back in. Here's McCoy. Now, very impressive through the passing game today. Over 200 yards. Looking for a TD here, and a flag is thrown as he tries to hook up with Pittman. Smith is covering James, number two on your screen there.
He's the one that got flagged. They're going to call him for interference. He made contact with Pittman well before the ball's arrival. It's being discussed, though.
Yeah, be careful now.
Talking it over. I think it's where they're going to place the football.
Pass interference. Defense. Number two. Give me a 15-yard penalty. First down.
And they'll move that half the distance to the goal. The penalties have been costly today for Iowa State. Least penalized team in the Big 12, though, with 19 penalties coming in. And that one, he had the left hand on. He was kind of riding him and pushing him a little bit. But, man, I thought that the coverage was so darn good. Gene Chizik calling a timeout. And I don't know, he can't challenge that. But he's upset. His coaching staff's upset about that penalty being called, I think.
It's their first time out of the half.
He's going to regroup his defense.
15 second timeout.
First and goal from the five when they resume play. Well, this is the first of a triple header here.
It's going to be a battle royale Norman, Oklahoma tonight.
Missouri still unbeaten, and their win over Illinois looking more impressive with each week that the Illini wins. Back to our game, and a touchdown pass. McCoy connects with Shipley again, and Texas tacks on another six. Singleton beaten on the play as Jordan Shipley gets his second TD of the day.
Yeah, Singleton in the first play of the game offensively for Texas thought he was going to have a safety over the top. This time he had Shipley, and he thinks he's going to have inside help because he's got outside technique. And boy, the relationship between linebacker and corner was not there at all. Very, very soft zone coverage there, and Shipley and McCoy tore it up.
5-yard pass from McCoy to Shipley, and the PAT. Bailey is on again, Ryan Bailey, and Shipley doing the holding, and this one is good. So Texas, with inside a minute to go in this first half, now up, and their kickoff to Allen Bell. And Bell brought down at the 21-yard line. And elsewhere around the Big 12, as they go to the half at 38-0 Oklahoma State. And this is a team that has really struggled winning road games, Dave.
Yeah, they have. I mean, they've lost two games for every victory on the road, and they've won two games for every loss at home. It's just been the reverse. And Oklahoma State bouncing back from the tough road defeat against Texas A&M. Saw them play last week, and Nebraska hangover from the Missouri thumping that they took in Columbia.
Sonic halftime report, of course, we'll have highlights of that. John Radigan and Pat Jones and the crew. Iowa State with just inside a minute to go here. And Oracle makes the tackle on Scales.
You know, we talked about Iowa State matching up with Texas in this game, Bill, and how there was very little margin for error. And when Texas scored on the first offensive snap because of a coverage breakdown, that was an area you can't afford against Texas. And then you come down the football field, and you're in the red zone, you have a holding penalty, to put you off schedule. You hook a field goal, and you leave points on the field. Another mistake you can't afford. So the margin for error is small, and Iowa State early in the game made a wide margin for error, making too many.
Maybe the final play here is Scales with 8 seconds and rolling.
Scales tries the right side.
Gene Chizik at this point saying, hey, we don't need to do anything foolish and get a pick and give him seven more. So they'll just take it to the house and make those halftime adjustments. And I don't know what they can do to try to get themselves back in this game. They're going to have to create some turnovers for one and probably something in the special teams game. Well, let's find out.
Yards right now. Colt, 3 touchdowns.
Jim, we are pleased. They've kept the ball too much, so we'd like to get more three and outs like we did after Dwayne and the defensive staff made some adjustments. We're still not getting the turnovers, but we haven't given one. So we need to finish the game. Colt's been just amazing. The protection's been great. The receivers are catching the ball. The kicking game's been good. But our deal is that we've lost the last 2 fourth quarters, so we've got to come out and play great this second half. Make sure we start forcing some turnovers. Got to knock a ball loose and then play well in the fourth quarter.
Game of the week.